Hi, my name is Jason Kang. I'm a full-stack developer working in South Korea. If you remember back to when we talked about six different things you can do with JavaScript, I told you guys how you can build a server with JavaScript using Node.js. So before we write our first blog post, let's talk about how you can run a server with JavaScript. Node.js is a runtime environment. Runtime environment is the environment in which a program or an application is executed. So Node.js allows you to run a JavaScript program outside a browser like Firefox or Chrome. Node.js does this by running the V8 engine, which is the core of Google Chrome, outside the browser. Node.js has gained a lot of attention from front-end developers who can now build a server-side application with the programming language they're familiar with instead of learning a new one. Node.js also allows you to use various NPM packages, which is the easiest and the fastest way to use JavaScript modules. A module is a block of code that can do something. So if someone has written a code to build a calendar, a chart, or a table, each of them can be considered as a module. If a module is registered in NPM, which stands for Node Package Manager, you can very easily bring them and then integrate them into your project. So if you want to add a calendar to your blog to check what kind of posts you've written on a certain date, you don't have to write every single line of code on your own. You can simply install a calendar package with NPM and integrate them into your project. So as we continue with our project, I'll show you some popular packages so you can get familiar with them. Frameworks like ExpressJS and Nest.js have become very popular. And in Korea, a lot of companies use Node.js as the backbone of their server. And this is because Node.js runs in a single process. This means that Node.js can handle thousands of requests in a single server. We are also going to build our server with Node.js. When you write your first post, we're going to send a request to the server, and Node.js will handle the request and save the post to a database. When someone else tries to access your blog, we're going to fetch this data from a server so that your visitors can read your post. And that's it for today. As always, if you want to learn something specific, please leave them in the comments below so I can answer your questions. Thank you, and stay tuned.